Tom Brady and Gisele Bündchen recently partnered with a huge cryptocurrency exchange, FTX. And there's a bigger story at play that I'm going to dig into. We're also going to take a look at the FTX token. I'm also going to discuss the FTX token, the FTX trading platform, and FTX's marketing, which is doing something very, very specific. And if you're an FTX holder, you're going to want to pay attention to this, or even if you're considering buying the FTX token, you're going to want to pay attention because what they're doing could be putting them in the same position that it's putting Robinhood. Currently, FTX is trading at $27. It was at an all-time high of about $61 when Bitcoin was at its all-time high, and it's trading very, very closely to what Bitcoin's chart is. But if you're looking for a longer-term play, and in this video, I'm going to talk about the reasons why. Hey everyone, my name is Randy. Welcome back to the Late Night Grind. On this channel, I am covering cryptocurrency news, the SEC versus Ripple, investment markets, personal finance, and stimulus updates. So if any of those topics interest you, go ahead and make sure you're subscribed. Click the subscribe button. Also, hit that bell notification icon. That way, YouTube will send you a notification when I release a new video. And if you're feeling really generous, I'd greatly appreciate if you hit the thumbs up button. It really helps out with the YouTube algorithm, basically tells YouTube to share this video with other audiences. So if you do that, I'd greatly appreciate it. And with that, let's jump into it. So FTX, they are a centralized exchange that has been around for about a year and a half now, and they've grown over 25-fold since then. In fact, in less than a year, they've grown to over $400 billion a month in trading volume. That's massive. Just to put it into perspective, even Coinbase, who is the largest exchange in the United States, did about $335 billion in April. During the same month. And also Binance, which is one of the largest in the world, currently transacts about $2.1 trillion per month in trading volume. So just so you can get a scale of where FTX is at. Now, one of the things that caught my eye was recently they actually went into a partnership together with NFL superstar Tom Brady and his wife Gisele Bündchen. They are both some of the biggest names in all of sports and entertainment in the celebrity world. Because if you remember a couple of weeks ago, I actually put out a video showing that Tom Brady actually put laser eyes in his Twitter profile showing that he was pro-Bitcoin, or at least pro-crypto. And this partnership basically solidifies that fact. So he is essentially going to be an ambassador for FTX, basically part of their marketing arm. And that's just the beginning of what FTX is actually doing and going after a target market. And you're going to see here in a minute. All right, so what's FTX so special? Why are they different than other exchanges? What do they do that's different? Well, so one of the things that really stood out to me, as soon as you go to their website, it says built by traders for traders. Now, one of the things that Robinhood became extremely well known for and extremely popular is because of their easy to use application. It was easy to get in and out of trades very quickly. It was a very user-friendly interface. Well, FTX, while it bills itself as built by traders for traders, offers all kinds of advanced options. It's one of those things that they're really going after a certain market of people who think they could make easy money or quick money. So FTX is essentially, it's a cryptocurrency exchange, but they actually offer a lot more. They actually have their own NFT marketplace where you can buy and sell NFTs. Of course, they have the whole cryptocurrency exchange, but they also offer something that's called tokenized stock trading, meaning you can actually trade tokenized versions of stocks such as Tesla, Apple, Google on their platform. They also have something called FTX Pay, which you can send and receive crypto, fiat, and what, as they say on their website, everything in between. They also offer a staking program as well as the ability to do margin trading. But let's jump back to their marketing for a little bit and go back to their target market and why I think this might actually put a target on their back, especially in the United States. So along with adding NFL superstar Tom Brady to their marketing arm, they've also purchased the naming rights to the Miami Heat Arena, which is now called FTX Arena. Not only that, just last week they announced a long-term deal with Major League Baseball. And before that, they actually entered into a partnership with an esports team in the largest contract in esports history, which is actually a 10-year, multi-million dollar deal. So you can see where I'm going with this. They're definitely going after the sports market. Why are they going after the sports market? Well, what has been so big in the sports market, especially in the financial world, within the last 5 years, sports betting, fantasy sports betting has been absolutely huge. The companies like DraftKings and FanDuel absolutely exploded. These are the markets that FTX is trying to crack its way into. built by traders for traders. That right there says, hey, this is something you can do very quickly to make that quick money. It's absolutely targeting the gambling community. Now, this is one of the reasons that they've exploded, not just in trading volume, but also in user base. In less than a year, they brought on over 1 million users that now use their platform to trade and exchange cryptocurrencies as well as other things. Their goal, as it says on their website, is to become the largest exchange in the United States within 2 years. Now, they have FTX.com, which is what basically all the global users use, and they have FTX US, which is another version of FTX, but it's US regulated. Now, I thought that was interesting because here's where they could be running up against some things, essentially the same thing that Robinhood's been running up against. So Robinhood has been wanting to go IPO now for quite some time, but the SEC has some inquiries that are kind of slowing some things down, namely because of the whole GameStop thing that happened back in the winter. The US regulators, the SEC, they had hearings in which the CEO of GameStop, as well as other hedge funds, actually had to sit there and be questioned by regulators on what the heck happened. Now, I watched several of those, and while extremely boring, there are some compilation clips that you can go watch on YouTube about what actually happened in those hearings and what was discussed. But here's what could be of a little bit of a concern concerning this type of marketing. So in April, the state of Massachusetts regulators actually sought to revoke Robinhood's dealer broker license because of the fact that, and this is what they claim, because Robinhood gave services to people with little to no investment experience, aka they targeted people looking for quick money. This is something that it was extremely cringeworthy to watch, seeing how these regulators, how these, what the crypto community calls the boomer generation, which has such a hard time grasping the crypto world and the crypto asset world, because you could tell that they were not big fans of the whole, as what they put it, the gamification of investing. Now, there is some truth to that because there's a lot of dangers in gamification and where you're essentially turning the stock market into a quick casino, or slot machine pool, where just a couple of swipes, you can get in and out of trades extremely quick. But in my opinion, it's still a lot safer than a casino. So what FTX is actually doing, going after this market, is absolutely the cause for their explosive growth over the last year. But it's also a cause for a little bit of a concern because of their type of marketing and who they're actually targeting, especially in the United States. Now, overall, I don't think this is going to really affect the price of the FTX token a whole lot if they would come through, if they would happen to get a target on their back from US regulators. Now, they might want to ask Ripple about something like that, but in the meantime, FTX Global is absolutely going gangbusters. So if you're looking for something that might be big in the next 2, 3, 4 years, that's something that could absolutely take on Binance, this could be one of those lower priced assets that at $27, if it starts to go as big as what Binance did, which was essentially about $600-$700 at its peak, which Binance even still is now over $300 where it's trading at, that's more than a 10x of where FTX is actually trading right now. And so their target marketing and their target services absolutely sets it up for this to potentially be a great 2 to 3 to 4 year hold. So if something like regulation or SEC issues don't scare you at all because you've been following the SEC versus Ripple case on this channel, well, then this might be one to look into as well. This is not financial advice. I'm not a financial advisor. I'm not a crypto expert, and I'm not a certified investment professional. With that out of the way, I'd appreciate it if you go ahead and give this video a big thumbs up. I'd really appreciate it. Thanks for watching till the end. And if you are new to the channel, go ahead and look at the community tab on this channel. I put out polls for the late night grind community to answer because I always love looking at the insights into the people that follow this channel. Don't forget to leave a comment down below, as well as leaving comments on those polls on the community tab. And normally I do cover the SEC versus Ripple. That's one of the biggest stories in all of crypto. So right now that's primarily what I've been following, but I wanted to put this out because there was some big news coming out about FTX, especially with the whole Tom Brady, Giselle Bundchen partnership. So I appreciate you guys watching, and I'll see you on the next video.